Senator Elizabeth Warren just released a campaign ad disguised as a DNA test. Or maybe it was a DNA test disguised as a campaign ad. In it, she ladles her DNA results with somber relatives and music, and even includes me. I'm touched, but that happens every time I take the subway.
I hear some of you are Republicans.
I am a Republican registered.
Yes.
What do you think of him calling her Pocahontas?
Well, I think it's ridiculous.
Yeah,
I think it's silly. I think it's crap.
What does Warren translate into Cherokee as? Spreading bull?
We did find 5 segments of Native American ancestry with very high confidence, where we believe the error rate is less than 1 in 1,000.
Now, the president likes to call my mom a liar. What do the facts say?
The facts suggest that you guys
absolutely have a Native American ancestor in your pedigree.
So her Native American ancestry may date back 6 to 10 generations. She's potentially 1/1,024th Indian, which is 0.09%. Using such standards, I'm Asian, which is why I can't get into Harvard. So no wonder she had to rely on sentiment and victimhood. But this really isn't about history, but her story and fixing it because it's a mess. Did she or did she not list herself as a minority in law school directories when it suited her, then removed it when it didn't? It's not about her background, it's about cheating. She's a white woman of vast European ancestry who went to the buffet of identity politics and took seconds, then thirds. Warren is Native American because she said so. She wins the 2018 Rachel Dolezal Award. So if we all do the same test as hers and find similar percentages, aren't we also eligible to claim the experiences of an oppressed group and their past grievances too? Her results now become the standard for anyone choosing a past that offers an edge, who can now skip ahead in admissions or jobs in places where diversity trumps experience. And so DNA tests become the new affirmative action, but at whose expense? Maybe no one, because if we're all a little oppressed, we're all good. Goodbye identity politics. If everyone is a minority, then nobody is.
That's a silver lining.
There is a silver lining. I think she did the nation a service. We are now all Native American. This is an interesting fact from Michael Aaron. What's his name?
Aaron's.
From a GOP spokesman. Mm-hmm. Danny, he used the New York Times sourcing. The average European American is 0.18. So the average European American is actually more Native American than she is. Did this backfire?
I think a little bit. It is interesting that a lot of the media were treating this as her response to Trump. But remember, she's going to have to get through a Democratic primary. And I imagine that if it maybe got down to the top 10,
yes,
that her opponents were going to use this. Donald Trump wasn't going to have to do anything. Mm-hmm. So I think she's overreacting a little bit. To your point, she has never actually had answered this question. Why did she not list it when she was applying to lower tier schools?
Mm-hmm.
Only listed it when she applied to the higher tier schools and then did not list it after she had tenure.
Mm-hmm.
That is the problem. Even if you are Native American, why did you list it when you only thought it was going to help you get an edge?
Good point. Juan, do you think that this is about Trump or is it about the people she's going to have to face before Trump?
No, I think it was about the effectiveness of the Trump attack, calling her Pocahontas and mm-hmm. ridiculing her in that way. And so I think she wanted to respond. And now I think it's like jujitsu. She thinks that she has put the pressure on Trump.
Mm-hmm.
The key thing here for me is that when the papers then asked the folks at Harvard, did you, in fact, consider this when you hired? They said no. When they looked at the University of Pennsylvania, in fact, I think they said at the University of Pennsylvania, they filled out a form explaining why they hired a white woman over minority candidates.
Mm-hmm.
So the whole basis, the foundation of the Trump attack was, hey, you use this to get ahead falsely, right? And it turns out that's not true, in addition to which she has some Native American ancestry.
I would disagree with you, Juan, and
okay.
you're shocked. But in 1997, Fordham University, the Law Review described Warren as Harvard Law School's first woman of color. So they had that cemented in their legacy. The funny thing about this today, though, for me, was looking at the way that the media reacted to this. Before really looking at the study and going through the numbers, it was Warren verifies that she's Native American. And the Boston Globe goes through a series of corrections because first they were saying it was 1/32nd. Then they go all the way to correcting it due to a math error, and it turns out to be 1 and 1,024. And so if you keep going down the line of the impossibilities of the point that you just brought up, Greg, in the sense that she is less Native American than the majority of Americans.
So do you guys think that she's owed $1 million by Trump?
I would actually say, well, Pete, I would say I think it would be good for Donald Trump to donate that money, write it off, and then thank her for saying, she points out, everyone in America is a Native American. She's done a service.
Thank you for doing the work for me.
Yes. Pay the money. He's got the money. Do it. Why not?
Yeah. And I can see the campaign T-shirts now, wearing it. I'm black. I'm Hispanic. I'm Jewish. I'm whatever. And on the back, you just like 0.09,
yes.
1.3, 2.4, whatever you want to be. To your point, it is exploiting minority status. She did it. She did it time and time again. And what the president did was devastatingly lay out how she used it for her own advantage, continues to use it for her advantage. And now she thinks she's getting ahead of it. No. She's creating more of a problem for herself. She can't get past it. This will make it worse for
her. Also, she just has terrible political timing.
Right.
We're 22 days to the midterm elections. The Democrats are losing ground with many Republicans, but they still have an edge, especially in the House, not in the Senate. But they're losing ground. But they have all this money. So they have all this. They could have used all day today, all this week. They could have been talking about that. But instead, she had to release this today. Like, why couldn't you do this a day after the election?
Because they think it's great.
I don't think they think it's great.
Get it out before the midterm.
I don't think so. Most of the Democrats that, like Jim Messina, for example, who was Obama's communications person, was like pulling his hair out, saying, why would you do this today? It doesn't help any of the Democrats that are on the ballot.
No, it's about her, though.
It's not about her. What I'm saying is that the story about the DNA test came the day after a Washington Post story about how great she's been to all of these Democratic candidates. Once they win their primaries, she's there with a phone call of support, with money. And so that was basically saying, wow, like she's doing a lot to try to build up a lot of support within the party, and then she does this.
Mm. Well, and the thing is, too, is she's having serious problems on the left, and she thinks that this is going to help her by claiming, with the unsubstantiated evidence, really, that she has minority status. On the left, that's a problem with the intersectionality argument, the white woman trying to represent minorities argument, especially when she's up against people like Cory Booker and Kamala Harris. And then on the right, people are saying, look, you're a liar. You exploited this to get ahead, despite you claiming that you didn't. There's all this evidence and a number of law reviews saying that you were chosen, essentially, or at least scouted on the fact that your name was listed as a minority as a professor before you got to Harvard Law. So she has problems on both sides of the aisle, both in a primary for 2020 and in a general election.
Well, I must tell you that from a Democrat's perspective, I don't think you're right. But it's interesting to listen to how you Republicans are responding, because
I was quoting Jim Messina.
Because I don't... No. Messina was saying the timing might be an issue, but not all of this kind of piling on. I mean, I think it's interesting. To my mind, what comes out is, here's another Trump fallacy. Oh, Pocahontas, he likes to ridicule people.
Wait, so 1% constitutes your ethnic background?
I don't care what it is. The fact is, because her family history, was that her great-grandmother would say,
we have great-great-great-great-great.
No. And she lied about it anyway.
I'm speaking about the
great-grandmother
who told her this.
Well, I don't get to tell a folktale about my background and then pretend like it's true.
Well, I don't know. I'm just saying that was her family story. She didn't know, obviously. That's why she had to have the test.
Sure. My 23andMe, to your point, has me at 2% Native American, which is actually more than her. So I'm welcoming her to my family. But it is. But to the point, and it's actually a bigger point. Is this the next step in affirmative action, DNA testing, so that every single person, when you're applying for college, you get the 23andMe or
You don't just get to check the box. Oh. You have to send in your results.
You have to send in your results. Yes.
That's scary.
No, I'm 1% Albanian. Remember that from the 23andMe?
That is true.
I was too scared. I was actually sitting at my desk last night about to do that test. We've been sitting there for a year, and I got freaked out reading the terms of service, and I put it back, and it's back on the desk.
We always talk about identity politics at the table. But if you are applying, you really want to be white upper class, let me tell you.
Well, she maybe not have gotten into the Harvard if she just got white.
No, but that's not true. Harvard says that's not true. And by the way,
Harvard says a lot.
I'm saying University of Pennsylvania, Harvard say the same thing. And then you said, but Fordham listed said.
Well, they did.
Well, guess what? We think this woman made it. But it didn't impact her ability to get the job.
We're going to probably see how Harvard really thinks. In this Asian discrimination case, we're going to see how they treat people for real, because we're going to be covering that, I think, wall to wall, aren't we?
It's going to be amazing coverage.
I know. All right.